Welcome everybody to the Satellite Gallery this evening on our beautiful spring summer evening. Thank you to everybody that has come out to be a part of the opening reception of the preschool classes exhibition that is up for a week. My name is Katie Norrington, and I work here at the Satellite Gallery. And I just want to do a couple introductions and thank you before we get started. There's some lemonade, there's some animal crackers, so please enjoy. First, I'd like to say thank you to a few people. There's a list by the door, but thank you to my wife, Sarah, thank you to Sherry Berg at All Saints Academy, and Tony Taparoki, and Linda Hyman, and Sarah Treckle, and Johnny McMahon, and Brady McMahon, and all the effort from parents and enjoying coming together for your students and child work. Jeff and Cindy, Jeff B., Cindy Abercrombie, and all the parents that are helping out this evening, Kathy May. And thank you so much for being here. It's very important. And this evening is about having fun and really enjoying what's on the walls and enjoying the energy that all of our kids, Mike and Ophelia, are part of this, but enjoying what they do and how they can play every day, because we as adults, we tend to play and we need to strive to play, but what we can see here this evening is play at its finest and play at its business, and it's something that we, I feel, need to really strive for in our day-to-day life as adults. I want to introduce Sherry Berg, and she's a Montessori preschool teacher that's been teaching for many, many years. But we've gotten to know her over the last 2 years with our daughter going to school in the class. And this is a collaboration between us and her class and your kids and All Saints Academy because of the work that Sherry is doing with her students. This is her energy that she's put forth into empowering the kids to do these things. And the kids have responded to that interaction and have shown us what they've done. So, this evening, this week, and so many days outside of this exhibition is about people like Sherry Berg. So, I want you to very humbly introduce Sherry Berg, and she now has the floor.
First of all, I have to say, I, of course, am not the artist. I just give them vocabulary, I give them tools, I might show them a method, I introduce concepts. Take it from there. Now, in my initial letter, I said, I quoted Picasso, and he said, every child is an artist. But I didn't say the end of that sentence, which is the problem, is how to keep them artists when they grow up. And I think if I ask, who are the artists in this room? The kids would raise their hands. Very few adults. J.D. probably would. But what happened between this age and adulthood? Where did they lose that opportunity or that freedom to express themselves like they're doing now? And I think part of it is the introduction of the youth. And I think these kids are not, that's not one of the tools that we use. So they're free to just do whatever and not have to worry. Another reason is I think well-meaning adults will often say, what is it? Instead of, tell me about your picture. And I think sometimes adults have tendency also to say, why is that yellow? It should be red. And if we just let the children express themselves, because they do so much better than we can express it, like I can express myself, with daily, on a daily basis. And I'm sure you can see that they've created beautiful, beautiful pieces of wood. However, this is the product. More importantly, is the process that they use to create these beautiful pieces. I will talk to them about harvest, I'll show them a method, and then it becomes an independent work, and they just go ahead and do it. I can show them one way, and they do it a different way, which is just perfectly fine. And it's to be expected. I give them a lot of vocabulary, like complementary colors, and we talk about the artists, but I also want them to know the artists, the famous artists, were children like they were. And they have stories, just like all of these kids have stories. The younger the child, the more confident they are in expressing themselves. And they have a tendency to lose that as they get older. I taught the older grades for a couple of years, and I was extremely frustrated because they were worried that things had to be correct. And that their art wasn't validated unless it was perfect, and unless somebody else said, it's fine. These kids are creating their work to themselves, not for me, not for the parents. They just do it. They know when they're finished. I don't have to tell them. They just stop. Or go on to another piece. It's just the process that's the most important. Following the Montessori method, I will show them, and then it comes to the end of work. Now, every day, crayon and pencil and glue and marker and paper and scissors, the basic tools are left out. They can do the art anytime they want. We have had some children who have walked in every single day of their preschool career, headed right to the art table, and started working. Art is very developmental. We have a couple who didn't even know what they are now, so we have to tell them. And that's just fine. It's just where they're at. Art is one of the least expensive hobbies that you can do. Most of the artwork that these children bring home is on the back of donated bulletin paper. I'm sure you've seen this. A box of crayons. Most of these works are just some of the watercolors, crayons, very, very basic, easy supply. And I think that's just important to let your child continue to have access to those supplies. And summer is a wonderful time to get out and just play and color the sidewalk and just go outside and paint. Also, places like this. Expose your children to other artists. The Minneapolis Institute of Art is free. And they have, from their collection, pieces of work, every single artist that we've talked about. So, it's all down the road. So just, my challenge to you is just to keep these young artists, I would like a few of the preschoolers to talk about their pieces a little bit. And I'm not sure, Catherine, do you want to talk a little bit? Do you know what you want to do? I'll tell you one thing. Thank you. This is Kevin. Kevin looked at a Paul Clay picture, and then he has lots of fishes, he has bubbles, he has seaweed. And the delightful thing is they just walk all the time, they're doing the heart. Okay, he's going to talk because I don't know. Okay. He's going to tell me at all times.
Thank you. Thank you. I Thank you.
too.
It was really, I felt like I'm not in it. But it was very interesting. I thought we had stuff.
You better tell them what kind of hat.